Now we're going to go to our computer, we're going to go to Explorer or Netscape or whoever you're using and go on to Google search engine or another excellent search engine. And what I want you to do is look up the words personality disorder, two words, put quotes around them, that might help, or character disorder or disorders, and you will find a number of pages come up. Within the first half a dozen, you'll find a number of references to various types of personality disorders. One of these references will have in it a very short test. If I recall correctly, it's a yes and no test. So it should take you about 10 to 15 minutes to fill this questionnaire out. You push the submit button, it'll go back to the computer that's doing it, and it will provide you with a list of personality disorders. Possibly 2 to 10 or 5 or 7, whatever is set up on that particular system. It will tell you the one which you're most like. So say in your case it came out that you were a paranoid personality disorder, that was the most likely. Now, going back, I want you to read everything from these 6 or 7 sites on paranoid personality disorder. I want you then print it out and study it. Study it very carefully. Now what I want you to do, since this has decided that you are, this is most likely what your personality structure is like, I want you to consciously recognize each and every one of these characteristics that the description provides you. Make a checklist. If it says you're suspicious of your spouse, highly suspicious of your spouse, what I want you to do is check that. So now what I want you to do is to exaggerate the suspiciousness of your spouse in your own mind. When you find yourself, in fact, being overly suspicious of your spouse, I want you to make a mental note that that's what you're doing. Ah, this is what I'm doing. Whether your wife or husband is doing anything against you or not is irrelevant. Makes no difference, particularly if you're a paranoid personality, because paranoid personalities love it. There's always truth behind the paranoid's delusions. Well, that's cool. But what we're trying to do is undo you. We're not trying to protect you. We're not trying to keep you the way you are. We're trying to undo you. Now, once you've completed that and taken on all those characteristics, at least in your own mind, and identified that behavior in your own mind, I want you to go back to the test results and see what comes next. Say, the next thing is a borderline personality. I want you to take on, learn, define every characteristic of that borderline personality, whether it is you or not. If it's not part of your nature, take it on anyways. Learn it, become it. Once you've done that, then I want you to go to the next one and keep on going to each and every type. I think there's somewhere between 7 and 10 types, depending on who you read, until you've gone through the entire group. And if you do this religiously, what you'll find out is that you'll start automatically catching yourself acting out the things that other people made you. Because your personality disorder, which we all have in one form or another, is something both your genetics to some degree and your environment turned you into. So this is called the de-victimization technique. I have found that when people religiously follow this, they can almost do away with any form of external consultation in regards to their life, in regards to their lifestyle, and in regards to how they interact with other people. In certain cases, you might find something called a dual diagnosis, that there'll be two that you're really heavy on, that you score really heavy on. For an example, one could be paranoid personality, dual diagnosis, alcohol. So even if you're not an alcoholic and don't drink, take on those characteristics. The idea is to bring out all that is in your unconscious, all that is in you, all your habitual traits and characteristics, as quickly and as rapidly as possible. Now, if you're not up to this kind of thing, don't do it, because it can really hurt. I don't mean hurt you. You will really feel bad about some of these things once you identify them. You might even feel terribly ashamed. That's okay. That's one of the things you're also going to learn from this exercise, is how to use the superego. That is the interjected, that means taking in, like an amoeba, the values and consciousness of this society and of your parents. You know when the superego is talking, anytime you feel shame, embarrassment, or anytime you hear the word should in your mind, you should do this, you should do that, you might do this, mostly the word should. Karen Horn and I had a phrase called the tyranny of the should. Fritz Perls worked with that whole concept in his Gestalt therapy. So keep it in mind, you can identify the superego. The idea is not to destroy the superego, but to steal its power. Because that superego helped you survive in the world that you were living in as a youngster and as an adult. So the idea here, we're now very clearly, is not to destroy the superego, but to steal its power away from its creation and give that power to you, the person that you're developing into.